Everyone ready to proceed?
Yes, sir.
Second?
Thank you, Judge. State calls Dr. Shondell Bouie.
Ma'am, would you please remain standing and place your left hand on the Bible? Raise your right hand, face my court clerk, and take it off.
Do you solemnly swear or affirm the testimony you shall give to be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
You did.
State your name for the record.
Hold down my hand, please.
By your side.
You ready?
Thank you, ma'am. You may proceed. Ms. Linder.
Thank you, Your Honor. Good afternoon, Dr.
Good afternoon. Yes, I do.
And how long have you known Lisa?
I've known her since high school.
Right. And what high school did you go to?
Neptune Senior High School.
Was Lisa in your class?
Not in my classes. We were just in the same year.
Okay. So you graduated the same year?
Yes.
And what year was that?
1987.
And did you know Lisa's grandmother, Elaine Palmer?
Yes, I did.
Where she was living while, do you know where Mrs. Palmer was living when you and Lisa were in high school?
Yeah, she was living in the house in Asbury Park.
And did you call the address?
Honestly, no.
Was it on 4th Avenue?
Yes.
What, if you happen to remember, was Lisa's grandfather alive while you guys were still in high school?
No, I never met Lisa's grandfather. He had died before I met him. Yes, I did.
And you and Lisa would visit with your grandmother together?
Yes.
Do you remember conversation, or let me ask you this. Was it common for you and Lisa and her grandmother to spend time together during those visits?
Yes.
And what part of the house would you spend time
in? In the living room.
And would the three of you talk?
Yes.
What about?
We talked about different topics. Marriage, finances.
Okay. On the topic of finances, do you recall any conversations with Lisa's grandmother concerning some property she might have set aside for the family?
Yes. She's, as far as I remember, she said she set aside some savings bonds for the family.
Specifically, any other details about what her intentions were with regard to these bonds?
Basically, for her family, for the investment purposes.
Okay. Was she joking when she made these comments?
No. She was very serious.
And from what you could observe, did Lisa seem to have any reaction?
Not particularly.
What about yourself?
No, I mean, we were in high school, so it was just kind of talking about stuff.
Okay. Do you recall Mrs. Palmer bringing this up on more than one occasion?
Yes, I do.
About how many times would she bring it up?
I can't say how many times. I don't really remember how many times, but it was more than once at least.
And with as much detail as you what do you remember her
saying? Well, I mean, I can't remember all the details. I just remember her mentioning that she had savings bonds.
Okay. Did she say when she had acquired them?
No. I mean, I don't remember. I don't remember that.
Do you remember if she said where they were at the time she was talking
no.
about them?
I don't remember that.
Did Lisa ever ask?
None of us ever asked.
Would you say that you and Lisa were very close at that time?
Yes. grandmother was very stoic and very serious, and she was very independent.
And at the time that she was having these conversations with Margaret Bonds, from your perspective, what was her mental, what was her physical and mental?
She was in good health, and good mental health, good physical health.
Now, you and Lisa have remained friends over the years.
Yes.
You're very close.
Yes.
Do you still live in New Jersey?
No.
Where do you live now?
Melbourne, Florida.
And how long has it been since you've lived in New Jersey?
11 years.
And what do you do in Florida now?
I am a pathologist.
And with regard to this trial, other than these questions that you were being asked and what you're going to be asked on cross-examination, has anybody approached you with regard to your testimony in this trial before this jury? Told you what to say?
No.
Were you interviewed by a detective from the prosecutor's office?
Yes, I was.
And do you recall who that was?
Yes, it was Detective Teresa Wilbur.
Do you recall approximately when that was?
2006. It's been a long time.
Would it refresh your recollection? I'll show you.
Yes, please.
Right. I'm going to show you what's been marked as S-22 for identification.
Has Mr. Fagen seen that?
I've seen it.
Very well, thank you.
I saw it in the audit project. I'll show you what's the point of this 22 for identification. Look at the bottom, there's a date.
2016, yeah, it was a few years. This is a lot.
Okay, and what does that report refer to?
Objection to what the report referred to.
Just say it.
That refresh your recollection when you spoke to Detective Wilbur?
2016.
Thank you. That's all I have.
Mr. Bender.
No questions.
Mr. Fagen.
When was the last time you spoke with Lisa Linder?
Last week.
And when you spoke with her, did you know that she testified in this courtroom?
Yes, I did.
Did she tell you that?
Yes, she did tell me she testified.
Did she discuss her testimony with you?
Some of it.
Now, I'm going to assume back in high school, that was the first time we met Ms. Linder, right, Duncan?
Yes.
How often would you go to Ms. Linder's home?
Once or twice a week.
So you would go to her home in Asbury with her grandma?
Yeah.
And that's where she was living?
Yes.
You're right.